Good evening and welcome to Flat Earth United. Joining me this evening is Martin Lietke, otherwise known as Flat Earth British. How are you doing, Martin?
Epic. Peace and love, Nathan.
Love to you too, Martin. And also joining us this evening is Mark, otherwise known as YouTuber Left Hand Path. How are you doing, Mark?
I'm very well, thanks. Thank you for having me on.
It's an excellent pleasure. First call to action. So if you are new to this channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon to keep up to date with videos from Nathan Oakley 1980. Before we went live, I asked Mark if he would give us a brief introduction to what we mean when we say the words in combination, satanic panic. So Mark, maybe you can start us off by telling the audience exactly that.
Well, the phrase satanic panic first came around in the 1980s, which was taken to mean a type of mass hysteria to do with assuming satanic or occult practices were going on in all manner of alleged crimes, most of which didn't actually happen when investigations were took place. And so it was referred to as the satanic panic. In modern terms, it can be basically any form of mass hysteria where they assume that some type of evil or some type of satanic or evil corporation is trying to steal babies or do something or even just try and brainwash them without any evidence or any proof. It's a panic based on satanic things. So satanic panic is basically another word for moral panics, witch hunts or mass hysterias.
I mean, you say there's no evidence, but often in Flat Earth, when we hear people labelled as Satanists, they draw the classic non sequitur conclusion as their proof or as their evidence. So we see that quite a lot. In other words, people believe in their own minds that what they've presented as evidence for you being satanic, not you, but the royal you, is nonsense. It's just non-related incidents or non-related information to anything satanic. Don't get me wrong, there are obviously instances where there will be people who are literally Satanists, and then you can't help but draw conclusions from that. But in the case of me, Martin, and yourself, Mark, we'll say this immediately: none of us are Satanists, correct?
Yes, absolutely. I'm not a Satanist.
Oh man, I'm a high-end God believer. Creationist flat earther.
You said you're a Realmian. Is that right? Realmian?
Yeah, I'm a Realmian. Yeah, there's a bit of disparity growing on with all these models, Nathan. I've seen it today. I've witnessed it today. But, you know, I don't think in these ways. I've always stated from since the very beginning, what we attain might not be attainable. You know, we might not be able to understand for reasons that we may not be able to understand. Has anyone ever conceived that? Maybe they don't understand. So, you know, I'm just putting it to the wind. I can feel it's a realm. I feel the creator all around us, like the Fibonacci sequence or golden ratio, is evidence enough for me of a creator. I've got a strong sense of it anyway. So I just go with that, Nathan. Not models, more realm, because that I'm living in, that I can experience. This these models are just all basically mind games, aren't they? There's something for the mind to juggle with to keep people happy. People need something solid, don't they? They need a comfort blanket or a teddy bear to cudge onto, like this globe model everyone's holding onto dearly. But for me, I don't need it, you see. I don't need that at all. For me, I'm quite happy to just go on my life believing this is a spiritual realm and a subjective experience for consciousness. And I don't think I'm quite off the mark.
You've made my life quite easy, Martin, because I was kind of asking that to segue into your beliefs about the creator, because obviously it's going to contrast the satanic theme of this show. But you've done that quite nicely. I'll go quickly and say that I have no beliefs in the creator. What about you, Mark?
I research things all the time, mostly just because I find them interesting rather than anything else. I don't have any set religion myself. I'm generally the type of person who wouldn't want to join organizations anyway. And most religions are organization based, so I wouldn't want to join them because there's going to be things I believe or don't believe that they would either want you to believe or wouldn't want you to believe. When I look at the what I see of the world and the universe, I think that it could well be created, or perhaps we could be creating the idea of it being created. And I think perhaps it's just all due to the person's subjective interpretation. Perhaps we don't know, but really, often a lot of it, I don't think, for me anyway, is worth wasting my time on, because I've got other things to actually to look into. So that's pretty much how I go. Just move from one thing to the other. But no, I don't really believe in anything specifically, just whatever I feel like on the day.
Same as me.
That's cleared that up. I mean, there is definitely, I'm just going to say this and be blunt about it, but it seems that the people who will label others as satanic have a certain belief system of their own, which is shocking. Anybody want to chime in on that?
Yeah, I do. I'm not sure if it's all to do with this theology of Alice Bailey and, Blavatsky that's been dragged through the 20th century. The Nazis even took this ideology, apparently, of resurrectionism and theolism. But I think it's just a holding on to that. People, it's like a craze with these people. I really do think, is there anything in it? Well, I really do believe the people that practice it think there's something in it. But is it actually manifesting a magical being? If you went to one of these dudes, would Baphomet magically appear on the end of the room? We're very fucking much doubting, right? So I don't believe God is evil, but I've experienced human beings, which you were swearing with the devil himself. They were that fucking horrible, out of frequency and evil. People that are playing my games, people that are slightly psychic, really evil people. So I think that's the devil. I think evil people who have chosen to be that course of life, through psychopathicness or social condition or whatever, I think that is the devil that they speak of. Okay, I don't believe it's a dude. I believe this irrationalization of trying to make of a theology from a time past, right? And I mean, this is like harping back to this era of the Middle Ages of Burn the Witch. It didn't actually exist. I thought, as a mature, advancing species developing, that we might have moved beyond that fucking ninth frame, realizing religion is control. For me, I'm on a real, it's a spiritual thing for me, the whole flat earth experience. So that part, the evil part, is a definite player. But the, with the Christ on one side and the devil on the other, having this eternal battle, for me, that's more damaging to humanity than anything they come up with. Honestly, it really is. Because how many wars have been actually fought over this theology? All of them. And they're still out of date. People are dying and being tortured and raped right this second somewhere on the plane because of that theology alone. If they just dumped that theology, we wouldn't need any of it, because no one would be, my God's bigger than your God, or my God's got a bigger beard than your God theology, which is just nuts. So in my mind, the only way for humanity is moving beyond that to a human spiritual experience. And we'll all be lovely people, because it's all in us anyway, isn't it? It really is. We don't need words to tell us how to behave, given by them again. So that's the way I feel about it. I really do. I think the signals are clear. I've been around a long time. I've experienced evil people. I've experienced witchcraft people as well, people who are probably practicing this shit. I was in the Merchant Navy, and there was a family on there that said the girl I was going out with lived in my cabin for 8 months, said her mother was a witch in a coven. And the moment I set eyes on that woman, I managed to punch myself in the nose full force and explode my nose. As she walked past me, took no notice whatsoever and said, hello, Martin. And it gave me the creepiest feeling I've ever had. So I don't doubt that there might have been something in it with those people. And that night, we was going to a party. A guy came up to me, had a Four Horsemen of Apocalypse tattooed on his arm. I caught the next train back to Cardiff. I run from these people. They were really creepy. Was there anything in it, or was it psychosomatic from me? It may have been psychosomatic for me, actually, the more I think into it now. Was there any realism in it? Probably not, actually. It was in the days of Led Zeppelin and heavy metal bands and that sort of thinking, if I'm honest with you. So thinking back, I think it was more me and my imagination. So is there any realism in it? I don't know.
I'm kind of glad you've said that you've thrown the accusation about, or at least thought it, not necessarily thrown the accusation about. Because I haven't. I mean, I've never felt the need to ever label anyone a Satanist. And what I was kind of alluding to with my question was about the people who actually throw out the accusation themselves. I don't know, Mark, maybe you can shed some light.
I think with satanic panic and moral hysterias in general, well, people often that do this think in terms of pure good and evil. And so they think of themselves as being at all times good and the boogeyman of being at all times evil. And I think people have a kind of comforting feeling in sort of lumping everybody together into this big devil worshipping evil pigeonhole. And of course, most of it's not going on. And I'll say, you know, I don't believe in a devil. I believe in evil, you know, it's all men and it's all designed for the, it's men controlling men. But with Satanic Panic, a lot of them do seem to believe that it's not men and that they're actually worshipping Satan. And, you know, it doesn't even have to be Satan. It can be sort of all manner of things which are simply different to what they believe in, which is a type of knee-jerk reaction. So, you know, I've seen these videos where people come out with something. I might not agree with it. I might agree with it. It doesn't matter to me. People are free to believe what they like. But then people are like, you're a Satanist. You're evil. You must be stopped.
Like women wearing trousers, for example.
Well, that was a joke thing, wasn't it? But it shows the extreme levels that it can get to, where something's different from what they believe, and therefore, it's objectively evil, which I think is a psychological thing. And you look at these witch hunts from the past, and that you know, this still goes on, but obviously not to those levels. But it was comforting. All our bad crops and all our sort of illnesses and child mortality and whatever, it's caused by those evil witches over there. It's nothing that we're doing. It's those evil people over there. So it's kind of a psychological thing, where really it's some of that's bad luck.
I think the witch hunting days with John Hopkins and that, if any of it was reality, I think it's more men locking up pretty women and being able to abuse them by using the law. Is I think what was going on there, because they're saying literally tens of thousands of women were literally taken, incarcerated, tortured, and burned to the stake. What happened to these women in the interim periods? I don't think, but they weren't women with big warts on them, the archetypical witch. These people were always attractive looking women. I think that's an element of that going on with these people, you know. Really too.
Well, I think at the end of the day, from as far as my experience is concerned with all this type of thing, is it always comes down to the actions of men in the end. It's not the actions of devils at all. It is the actions of men. So, you know, once you strip all that away, it's just the actions of human beings.
I put Anton LaVey on the trailer for this, and it got demonetized. So it's obvious that this, just the idea, or just, it could have even just been the title, Satanic Panic. We shall see when this gets rendered, if the same thing happens to this. But I think what you're saying is, it's just, the trousers example isn't probably the best one. I was going to use something like Vishnu. So you've got Hindus worshipping an idol, in essence.
Yes.
And that's abnormal to a Christian, or to me, let's say. So I would see them, you know, worshipping a many-armed god and go, wow, that's weird. Must be satanic.
Yeah, that's how a lot of it starts. And I see this in comments, and that's kind of how I got into making the comedy videos, because I actually just thought it was funny. Where, you know, it's like I used to say it all the time with, well, I can prove that this is satanic because there's pyramids in it. Look, what more proof do you need? Pyramids. Well, that's blooming Egyptian. You know, that's not, you know, it's just, if that's different from, it's different from Christianity, therefore it must be objectively wrong and objectively evil. And I actually just found that quite funny when I saw that, because it was just so silly. And so that's why I made those videos in the first place, really. Because, you know, they just don't know when to stop some of the Satanic Panic brigades. But I think it's all right having a laugh at it. But the original Satanic Panic in the 80s, it did result in some perfectly innocent people having their lives totally thrown upside down based on these accusations. Like, you know, the preschool teachers, the McMartin preschool case. There was the preschool teachers were kind of actually imprisoned for supposedly satanic crimes against children, and none of it happened. But because of the sort of, you know, snowball down a hill effect, people, even to this day, there are still a small subset of people who sincerely believe that these perfectly innocent people were involved in these crimes. And I think that's really a different ballpark entirely, when innocent people are actually being
in the 80s.
The original Satanic Panic in the 80s, yeah.
What happened to these individuals that were labelled as satanic in the 80s?
In the McMartin case, they were actually imprisoned, and they have been let free now, thankfully. But, you know, the...
Right, they were jailed for being satanic.
They were jailed for apparent satanic crimes against children, which were... None of it happened. It was a complete farcical panic. It's like stranger danger taken to the extreme levels. You know, there's a little bit of sense in strict, you know, to tell your kids to be wary of that guy down the park who says he's got a bag of sweets, but you know, you can take things too far, and especially when it involves in people being physically accused of doing something without any proof at all. I take great issue with that, really. So,
well, we have a similar thing in modern times with Pizzagate, but again, it's back to, is it the man? I'm not going to say it is, but ultimately speaking, if we were to now collectively, us three, say that Pizzagate's just purely satanic, I blame it on Satan, you would short-sightedly be ignoring the actual perpetrators, if indeed they are guilty of any crime. You know, of, I can't think of off the top of my head another paedophile case that's actually come out with a guilty verdict, but if there was one, I'd use that.
Well, Heath is in court. This Heath's case, Edward Heath, the former British Prime Minister, who everyone knows has all the way along has been a paedophile. So they just reopened. They're saying it's a waste of time. You know, what the guy, you know, what at his age, or I think he's even dead, isn't he? And what's that going to prove? But they're going ahead with it. So there's a lot of cases coming out in the British judicial system for getting these people. So I keep thinking there's someone in the background that might be an all right dude, but it might not be. It might be just, you know, a bit of a purge or something with these people. But yeah, since Operation Yew Tree, it's a snowball, doesn't it, against these people? So,
he was Rolf Harris, wasn't it?
Rolf Harris, friend with the Queen. He spent more time with that woman alone than practically anyone other than her husband. He painted her portrait. He spent endless hours with her. And the guy turned out to be a paedophile, went into an open prison after 1 year, and now he's out. And they're all getting out. Apparently Charles Manson's out this year. So it's not that he was a paedophile, but apparently he was a Satanist, wasn't he? But all of these people, I can't help thinking that they're sort of purging. They want it out in the public mind, especially with Pizzagate. That flooded the internet, didn't it? So how much of that can we even believe? Or is it them again playing a dialectic? You can never know with the internet. This is the problem. I live in a very sheltered world from all these things, I must too. But I think the hysteria thing is
definitely... People have labelled parts of that as satanic. You know, it's blamed on the devil.
Sorry,
today,
I appear to have been cut off and just reappeared.
I can see.
There is, we've got you back loud and clear. We're just talking about the modern phenomenon of the same thing that happened in the 80s with the Satanic Panic, where people will literally blame Satan for paedophilia.
Well, yeah, absolutely. You know, there are actual Satanists. There are Satanists out there. There are people who are physically Satanists. Now, most Satanist organizations are very much atheistic in their beliefs, or their lack of beliefs. Pretty much secular humanist with horns. That's like what the Church of Satan is like. I think it's quite silly to say that that somehow makes the people sexually attracted to children. You know, it's a totally different ballpark.
Summarize for people who are watching, what makes a Satanist? What is an actual Satanist?
I think an actual Satanist, well, you know, there are different types of Satanists. First of all, there is atheistic Satanism and theistic Satanism. Now, atheistic Satanism, which is like your Church of Satan, your Anton LaVey, your Satanic Temple, all that type of thing, it's kind of like a very high individualistic, egocentric, social Darwinist, might is right sort of philosophy. It's very hard right, not really right wing, but it's kind of like similar to the philosophies of people such as Ayn Rand, Ragnar Redbeard, and things like that. So it's rampant individualism, capitalism, and against the herd. It's against the huddling instinct. And it uses Satan really as a symbol of what Satan means in Hebrew, which is the accuser. So it's like saying, you know, no, I'm not going to bow down to your printed idols of religion or of politics or whatever, because, well, why should I? Well, you know, we should live our lives carpe diem. It's basically a life-focused thing. Whereas theistic Satanism is different. They actually physically believe in Satan. Now, that's a very small type of Satanism. Now, they're not interested in eating babies either, because let's be honest, you'd have to be off your head, totally bonkers, to want to eat babies. It doesn't matter what your religion is. You'd be very hard-pressed to find any human being out there who wants to kill or eat babies at all. It's just not going to happen. It doesn't matter what their religion is. But theistic Satanists do actually believe in a Satan, so they may say prayers to Satan or something like that. It's a bit silly in my opinion, but you know, that's the two different types of Satanism that are actually out there. But the type of Satanism we hear about in panic cases really is the level of high fantasy. It's just not happening anywhere, as far as one can ascertain logically anyway.
The fantasy that the people who are perpetrating any particular crime, if there is even a crime being perpetrated, are theistic Satanists, but they are having that projected onto them. In other words, there isn't actually any Satanism at all. I mean, a good example would be someone like IPS, who I think would fall into the former category anyway, as opposed to, but he is, people literally project that he is worshipping the devil, when in fact he is the, well, like you described in the former, you know, a kind of anti-establishment, and will even, to take the piss, say Hail Satan in chat feeds, mainly to rile up the people who will project the theistic Satanist onto him.
Certainly Levian Satanists or people with that type of philosophy would enjoy a bit of Halloween-esque joking like that. I can always remember Anton LaVey saying that if he ever was afforded the privilege of doing an interview with a fundamentalist Christian, he would like to wear comedy horns on his head with a completely straight face all the way through the interview, you know, just for the hell of it. So I think people like IPS may be going for that in a way. But when, you know, when somebody comments he's physically worshipping the devil, I mean, really, how many people would sincerely believe that? You know, I think the serious message behind my comedy videos was, do you sincerely believe that Harry Potter is teaching your children to worship the devil? Of course not. Yeah. It's really, really silly to say that.
If I hadn't read an Alistair, a Dennis Wheatley novel, or watched an old Dracula film, I would never even thought in these ways of the devil. Just where I've got it all from. It's Hollywood or Dennis Wheatley novels. It's from them again, isn't it? All of it, really, all the Satanism.
The best parody ever was in Happy Gilmore, and played the mother. There was a very famous, who was it? Played the mother.
Tia, in my mind's eye.
But she would label everything as the devil. You know, girls, they're the devil. Doesn't matter what he brought home or would talk about that he was taught in school. You know, science, the devil.
Foosball as well, isn't it? For football, foosball.
Foosball is the devil.
It's quite interesting, though, that some people who were brought up in that very, very strict household where like everything's forbidden because it's the devil can have the opposite effect on them. Everybody's favourite accusation of a Satanist is this Aleister Crowley chap. Now, Aleister Crowley, just for the record, it wasn't a Satanist. He never worshipped Satan, ever. He had a philosophy known as Thelema, which simply means will or intention. But Aleister Crowley was brought up as a child in a very strict religious household called the Plymouth Brethren, and they were sort of pathologically anti-pleasure. You know, just eating your dinner and enjoying it was the work of the devil. And of course, what happened when he became a teenager? He wanted to rebel. He wanted to have the sex that was forbidden. He wanted to eat the foods that were forbidden, do the things that were forbidden. And that's why he started to style himself as this, the great beast, because that's what he had been led to believe it was if you went out and enjoyed your life.
Yeah, well, look how people were then, Mark, how conservative they were. You know, you had to take a girl, introduce them to your parents and all this caper. So, you know, in that day and age, I bet that was right off the cuff.
Well, you know, absolutely.
I think
quite, if you, it was a lot of stuff that Aleister Crowley was coming out with wouldn't be particularly shocking to our modern ears, but it certainly was at the time. And so that's where some of that comes from. But it can have a repressed atmosphere. That's basically what I was saying. If you're brought up in that environment, it could repress you. And then when you become a teenager and you break free, you go out and live it up to an extreme level because you've been told that everything's evil. But really, you don't believe it. You know it's not evil. And perhaps even the people accusing them of it evil don't sincerely believe it to be. It's just all philosophy.
I don't know. There's people who say it with such conviction that I'm firmly of the opinion that they do believe it. They actually believe what they say when they accuse others of being Satanists. And they think from the beginning, they think they've found proof. You know, they think they're whatever bit of nonsense. You know, that ad for this will no doubt get me labelled as a Satanist.
Well, how will this be interpreted then, Nathan? How do you think this tonight's hangout will be interpreted? It's obviously open discussing these things to try and understand them clearly and, you know, responsibly. But how will it be interpreted outwardly?
Discussing the devil is the devil! That's how
it well, you know, they if you look at... Sorry, Martin.
Yeah, I know. Sorry.
People would look at the avatar that I'm using on this and say, this is hard proof that this person is a Satanist, as well as his username. He's got to be a Satanist. But, you know, you look at that avatar, there's nothing satanic in the avatar. It has an Egyptian eye of Horus in the middle, which is an Egyptian symbol, remember, not Satan. The cobras are Egyptian. In fact, the entire thing is Egyptian with Masonic overtones. Now, this is another thing that I've heard with IPS saying, and I'm completely with him, and people are terrified of associating with IPS because of his links to Freemasonry, because they think that Freemasonry is satanic again. And, you know, Freemasonry is not satanic. And this is kind of where I sort of draw the line. And if people are going to be a truther and if they want to look for the truth, then, you know, you've really got to actually research these things and
deal with the realities instead of what Russian Vid says, that everybody is satanic, blah, 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 because a lot of people just go with this, don't they? If it's against any certain way that they say, which is usually the way of strict Holy Bible thinking, anything outside of that, then they're obviously really, really evil and satanic by nature. But is that what's going on? Or is it just everyone just being hysterical and just, you know, pigeonholing things again? Because I think that's what's going on, isn't there?
A lot of it is pigeonholing, yeah. It's this idea that you can sleep safe in your bed knowing that it's all the evil people are in this pigeonhole. Because you look at the satanic panics and they're not just actually accusing people of being Satanists. I mean, sorry, they're not just accusing, like, actually satanic things as being Satanists. I've seen people on these flat earth hangouts discussing things such as this urine therapy, for example.
Yeah.
And people jump in, that's satanic. What the hell's urine therapy got to do with Satanism? Come on.
No, the Chinese been practicing it for a couple of thousand years, apparently.
You call yourself a truther and you come up with things like that. And then somebody mentions Freemasonry, that's satanic. It's not even religious. It's a fraternity, you know, so that they link anything they don't like into the big boogeyman of Satanism. And they usually use Baphomet as a symbol to represent that. And that's not Satan either. You know? So if you really want to look for the truth of things, often the truth's going to be pretty boring when you find it. It's not going to be what you think it is. I've said this before about Aleister Crowley. If people actually go and pick up one of those books and read it, they're going to think,
yeah, the cover says
God, this is a load of crap. This is really boring. You know, it's not what I thought at all.
Yeah, no, I thought that. Yeah, I've seen it on a... I leaked the PDF. I can't remember. One of the YouTubers put it out there. And on the cover, it said something to do with love. The love of people, you know, the love of life. Right. Love, that doesn't seem too evil to me. What do I know? But, again. Sorry. Yeah, don't stop on me, guys.
Oh, sorry.
All right, Martin, I was getting sharing the stream. My apologies. So,
I think one of the dangers with satanic panics is when you change from an amorphous, those people are Satanists, into a Bob Smith down the road is a Satanist who's eating your babies, because then that's actually criminally libelous. And of course, it wouldn't stand up in a court of law. You need to have actual proof that this person is committing the horrendous crimes of which you are you know, saying that they are. So, like, you know, you look at that Hampstead satanic panic, which is a modern
Lucifer, apparently, weren't they? They were worshipping Lucifer, apparently.
No, you know, from my experience, it should be fairly obvious that there is no satanic cult that's sending thousands of babies in the post via parcel force, mm-hmm. cooking them in McDonald's, making shoes out of the skin, and keeping 8,000 baby skulls in a bedroom drawers. I'm sorry, that's not happening at all. That's simply a completely illogical thing for anybody to say. When we actually think about that on a logical basis, it's not happening. But there are people out there who really sincerely believe it. They genuinely believe that this is happening. But the question is, all right, let's go with it. Let's pretend it's happening. And what doctrine is it that's telling these people to do this? The Satanic Bible doesn't have anything like that. The Christian Bible, Satan doesn't call out for anything like that. Your Thelema, no. Your Masonry, no. Your Goetia, all that occult, all this occultism and witchcraft. None of that calls out for anything like that. All this stuff is made up in the minds of...
Sorry to interrupt. So my impression would be that it was being raised a Christian. I know about the devil. And my assumption would be that it was that devil. I mean, is there a different devil that we're referring to? I just assumed it was the Christian one.
Well, I would... Most people certainly, yeah, they'll be coming from a Christian devil perspective with these things. Obviously, all the different cultures have their own devils and their own demons. But with satanic panics, yes, they're absolutely believing that it's the Christian devil that these people are worshipping or bowing down to or whatever it would be.
Is there another one? Is there other religions that have this antithesis of the good, you know, the good Samaritan, the Jesus character? Is that in other religions? I should know this.
Well, the sort of major religions, I think Islam has its own version of a devil. I think it's even Shaitan, which is basically Satan again, you know. But mystery traditions and religions such as Wicca and things, which people often assume are satanic, generally don't have the devils in them. They may have good and bad acts or positivity and negativity and all that type of thing, but they certainly don't have like a big devil in hell that's there to sort of doom you to hell and judge you and all that. That's generally a Christian type of thing. And of course, a culture that's not Christian isn't going to worship Satan, because Satan isn't a deity in their religion at all.
So how do we combat this then? I mean, before we go on to how to combat it, how do we experience it? Because I don't know about you, Mark, I don't know you well enough to know if you've, I assume you have, just from what you've told us about your logo and such, that it's already happened with some of your videos where you get accused of it. But I want to kind of, the three of us, discuss how this affects us, basically, before we talk about how to address it.
I think if it's just sort of silly comments and silly accusations, then, you know, I'm not really bothered, because you can't stop somebody from sincerely believing it. If somebody really wants to sincerely believe that these people are Satanist shills who are employed by Masons and they're hiding 33s in the videos and all this, then they're going to continue believing it no matter what proof is given to them. I think where it would become a problem is if they started to physically accuse actual people with their real names of committing crimes, for example. That would be, you know, an actual criminal thing. You know, it's a bit libelous statement. But yeah, I have experienced, obviously, people claiming that I am a Satanist and all this type of thing. When, you know, I've read the Satanic Bible. It's a good book. That doesn't mean that I'm a Satanist. You know, you can read something and say, yeah, that's pretty cool, or I didn't like that, or whatever. I've read the Bible, but I'm not a Christian. You know, it's just read, you know, it's, where do you draw the line with logical interest in something based
on... That's going to need a bit of qualifying. So, good book, in quotes.
The Satanic Bible. Well, the Satanic Bible is actually taken almost entirely from an earlier book called Might is Right, which is a philosophy book. Basically, the Satanic Bible is a type of philosophy that, when I first read it, I came to it because it was open about various things that religion in general wasn't at the time. And so when you read it as like a teenager, you think, wow, this makes sense, you know, because you're this rebellious teenager, you know, and you think this is accepting of different lifestyles that aren't the herd, and you think this is fantastic. But really, you know, I mean, would you go to the extent of saying the Satanic Bible's so good that I'm going to go and join the Church of Satan? And us, in fact, even LaVey said that most people who read it wouldn't want to join. It's just the type of people who would like LaVey.
Obviously, from a Bible point of view, the Bible, I'm not going to, I'll just say it could be used to convert people, but you're saying the Satanic Bible is no such thing. It's not used as a conversion tool.
No, well, I mean, LaVey stated that Satanism...
The Satanic Bible, so maybe give us a bit more, you know, breadth to what's actually in it.
The Satanic Bible, it says that Satanism demands study and not worship, which is quite an interesting statement, and it's a logical statement. So it's a statement of understanding the world based on fact rather than on faith. Its basic content is of that instead of waiting for a God to save you, save yourself. Instead of confessing your sins based on the fake guilt that some priest has given you. Go out there and live your life, because you've only got this one life. This is the only life that you have. So, you know, you're not hurting anyone with your lifestyle. It's not hurting anyone, because it must be said that this Church of Satan they won't tolerate illegal activity. So it doesn't, you know, if you hurt animals or children or something, that's completely against what these things believe, and it's life focused. Essentially, it's atheism with like a little bit of quirky symbols and things added into it.
The thing that caught my attention was the first thing you said, which was that it's based on paying attention to what you can prove and what is real rather than what is faith. So essentially, just to tie this together, the thing that is the most logical has been demonized as the most evil thing imaginable and given this name, Satanic.
Yeah, I think LaVey says in the Satanic Bible, I haven't called this Satanism, they have, which is like saying that if I came out with a philosophy saying you can live your lifestyle, now your lifestyle doesn't harm anyone, you go out and live it, you know, go and eat, drink and be merry. Like that Ruby Atavoma Khayyam says, you know, take the drink your wine and enjoy your life, because the bird of time will soon fly away, type of thing. You know, go out there and live your life and enjoy it. And someone says, that's satanic, that's evil. They've called it satanic, not me. So that, but yeah, so absolutely, the logical way of looking at the world and the logical way of understanding and accepting people's differences and accepting people's eccentricities is demonized as the most evil thing in the world, where really it's pretty sensible, really.
I mean, you said it's bad in the book to hurt or harm or commit crimes, but are there any altruistic elements like there are in Christianity, which is mostly altruistic in reality, I think?
Well, because it's similar to sort of philosophies like Ayn Rand, it's generally not that altruistic. It's more individualist, you know, it's like The Virtue of Selfishness by Ayn Rand, that type of thing. But certainly it would... kindness, I think it says something like, I can't quote it off by heart at the moment, but it's like, it's fine to conform, you know, you would conform to the wishes of the people whom you love and care for. You would protect your family because they mean the world to you. And, you know, we all exist with things that we value and we care for our values. You wouldn't want someone to go and sort of harm your pets or something like that. So you would care for your pets very much, and you would be dead against somebody that would want to harm them. So, you know, it has that.
More empathy based than perhaps.
Yeah. Yeah. That would make more sense. Yeah.
Okay. You've been a bit quiet, Martin, unlike you.
Not when Mark's talking. I'm always absorbed when Mark's talking. I learn by Mark. You know, I'm quite in the dark with the subject, if I'm honest. Only picked it up in the last few years where the people have read a bit on it. It's just, I like, it's know thy evil, you know. And to me, like Mark said, the only life you know, to me that is right and wrong. I think that it's the only life we're aware of. But I definitely think we're karmically connected. I think that there is more than this. I think I'm definitely a believer in reincarnation and the eternal spirit. I don't believe spirit dies. I don't think death is real. I really, really don't. I just think we're passing through experimental, whatever it is, this strange-ass realm we all find ourselves in at the same time, which is really strange in itself when you think about it, that we're all here right now at the same time in reality. Just sort of, you know, got a bit of a poignancy to it, I think.
Oh, yeah. I think you're probably absolutely right. But what I mean by that is, you're never going to be Martin Liedker again. You know, that Martin Liedker is a one-off, and that's going to be, you know, so if you're going to be born 100 times again in the future, or you have been born in the past, it may have had the essence of you, the spirit of you, but it's not you. It's not living in right now in 2017.
You're never
going to live again in 2017. So get out there and enjoy the things that you can enjoy in 2017.
I did all of that, man.
They're never going to come again.
This Dorian Gray theology I carried out in my younger years. I traveled the world and experienced everything that I thought there was to experience, trying to find myself, as the saying goes. And all of the choices are there for me to have. I got free will. I can do whatever I want. So what do? I choose it to discuss and learn with friends, have a cup of coffee and a smoke. That is me. So I've had my choice in life to do things, but that is it. You know, really simple things in life. And so,
I absolutely, you've got to cling to the things that
the imagination
make you feel like you. You know, it's a different topic, really. It's like, you know, what makes us is a different topic.
Experience of life, the things you go through in your life makes. I've had a hard life. I'm sure it shows on my face. But if it hadn't been the way it had panned out, then I wouldn't be the person I am now. Because I've worn all the t-shirts, so I can help people with experience that I've had. I can actually talk because I fucking, you know, I've done it. So I'm not talking through ignorance. I can do this on, you know, almost any level, with almost any level of person, either if it's a university professor, to someone on the street. I can absolutely communicate with anyone on the plane on an equal level. So, you know, that's the spirit thing, I think. I don't know. Just me. Sorry, I just waffled then, guys.
It's right, Mark. You've got loads of segues in there because you can talk about things like life after death, or reincarnation, and they're cool. In my mind, they're one and the same thing anyway, in a way. But I don't believe in either, you know, because I see no hard evidence for it. You know, I don't see any hard evidence for life after death.
I've had some hard evidence. A couple of people in my life that I met, a girl I went out with, her sister, her daughter, went up to a grandmother and said, "I was your mother in the past life," and it was really creepy. But only she came out with a load of details. It would have been impossible to know. Freaked her eye out. So families are karmically connected. Like you say, it's not the same person. It's not the same look, but it's the same soul. And she says that she got the connection with the soul, and it felt like that soul too. So I've heard other stories of the same people. My grandfather, when he was in World War II, he was in Milan in World War II. He took the entire crew around the city, and he knew everything around the next corner. And he'd never been there before. I've done the same. I've been in foreign cities and knew everywhere. I managed to get back to the ship in the dark, walking miles across cities, and I would always get there. Either an internal radar or I would have been there before. And
we'll save this argument for another time, because I've said already, Martin, on other streams, that I think that's you. But I want to get Mark's opinion on this. So maybe if I rephrase it slightly, which is to say, if you've got life after death, well, I don't know, how much should I lead you? I'm not going to lead you at all.
I think
there's more beyond this.
I think with most of the, if you look at this occult stuff and a lot of the esoteric stuff, it always often talks about duality, or there's this kind of duality thing going on, and you can look at it really mystical if you want, or you can look at it just purely physical, and that's like a balance. And so I think there is part of our life where we sort of contemplate the grand mystery of existence, you know, and what life is. And all this flat earth stuff has all been about saying the earth's clearly not, you know, it's different to what we're being told. Now, I'm not going to that from a religious perspective, and I never have done. I've never pretended to. But you know, there is a grand mystery to existence, the universe, where do we come from, and all that, which is a grand questions which probably have no right or wrong answer. But there's also the other side, which, as you say, you just want to sit down with a cup of tea and enjoy it. And you know that you enjoy it. You don't need someone to say, but why do you enjoy it? What is it all about? What does it mean? You just know that you like it. And so you can believe anything that you like about what happens after death, as long as you don't neglect the life here and now, because you know right now, you absolutely know that you've got the life here and now. And that's what's important to me, which is to live the life right now.
One of the things that's projected onto Satanists, and it's mainly with imagery, you know, I had a quick Google search to produce the advert and just typed in Satanist, and most of the images that came up were surrounding, or looked like they were surrounding, death. So maybe how do the Satanists actually approach the subject of death? Because what's projected onto them seems like they just revel in death.
I think some of that's just silly imagery of... it's like Halloween-style imagery, a lot of it. But I think a lot of it is memento mori. So memento mori, which is the images of death. You know, it's just saying, remember you're mortal, and remember that whether you believe in an afterlife or not, your days in this body are going to be limited. So if you remember you're mortal, and memento mori, you're less likely to waste your time on frivolities, or waste your time mourning and groaning, and get out there and live your life, because you don't know what's coming. Don't get me wrong, I hope everyone watching has a long and fruitful life, because why wouldn't I? You know, if you love life and you have life as your philosophy, why wouldn't you want people to have life and enjoy it? It wouldn't make any sense.
Reminds me of a line in Red Dwarf. So he was saying some people don't get the privilege of an extended life. For some people, it's just mind that bus. What bus? Splat.
And the, in that Ruby Atavoma Kai arm, you know, where it mentions, talks about death as people who have finished their glass of wine a short time before you have finished yours. I think that pretty much sums it up for me, really.
Very poignant. Love it.
So I'm going to have to leave in a minute. Perhaps I could just finish by the question of how to stop satanic panic.
That would be brilliant if we can wrap it up with the with yourself, Mark, just by the resolve. That would be awesome.
I think really it's all just a matter of winding right back and just going purely with, you know, just say, right, is this really logical? Is this really going on? Like, you look at, without getting carried away with the emotion, because people get carried away with the emotion and all these things, and you have to ask yourself, first, you know, is this logical? Is this really, do you sincerely believe that this would happen? And if you do, which a lot of them will, the next step is to actually research it, and don't be afraid to research it. If you think Freemasons are Satanists, go and start reading about Freemasonry. Buy books on it. But buy books on Satanism and the Satanic Bible. Read this stuff. Read your Aleister Crowley. Read all of it and read it sincerely and try and get into the mind of the person who may actually believe it. And perhaps it's not what you were thinking it was after all, in the end.
Actually getting the knowledge demystifies what your current belief is. With that, Mark, I'm going to round out our main part of the show and say a absolutely massive thank you for coming on. So be sure to subscribe to Left Hand Path's YouTube channel. Mark, it's been an absolute pleasure having you here.
Thank you very much for having me.
And I will also, on this stream, round out and say a thank you to Martin. Hopefully he'll hang around for a little bit afterwards and chat to us on OBS. So thank you to you also, Martin.
Yeah, thanks, Nathan.
Right. I'll leave now. So, thanks a lot. It's been a good show. Thank you.
You'll be up, don't worry.
Pleasure having you here, Mark. And to all of you who have joined us in the live chat, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And once this video renders, give it a like and leave a comment below. I've been Nathan Oakley. I'll see you all in the next video.
Peace.